a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Oh, it's a beautiful day. Get our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We are taken by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Cultivate wisdom. You don't need to accumulate knowledge to become wise. Anyone can become wise. When you become wise, you respect your mind, you respect your soul, and you respect your body. When you become wise, your life is controlled by your heart, not your head. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials trading up 688. NASDAQ is up 341. S&P's up 84. That's a gain out here in the NASDAQ of 3.1%. Inside the S&P's 2.5 and 2.5 in the Dow Industrials. Gold. Gold contract trading up $13.90. At $19.57 an ounce. You have silver up 22 cents, $27.21 an ounce. Light sweet crude up $1.25, $38.01 a barrel. Notes and bonds. We have the 10-year right now down 4 ticks, trading out at 139.08. The 30-year down 23 at 175.18 in King Dollar. King Dollar's down 185 ticks, trading 93.260. The euro is at 118. The yen is at 106.22, and the British pound's at 129 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do we got? Well, you got a heck of a bounce. There's no doubt about it. The bottom line is that, once again, it looks like we have a 24-hour market on the way down. That being said, what we haven't done out here yet inside, well, the S&Ps, this is quite a run in the S&Ps. There's no two ways about it. You take a look at this. The highs of yesterday, overnight yesterday was at 34.47. If we take a look at where we basically opened up yesterday, the bottom line is that you are higher than the where we were at the open yesterday. That being said, if we go over and we take a look at the SPY, the real kicker here, folks, is going to be how do we close? The reason that I'm saying that is this, is that the gap on the SPY is 342.25. Well, we're at 342.19. We hit 342.23. So if this is just a close of a gap and you back down, what you're going to see is this. When you have an ABC structure in the making, an ABC structure, folks, is two straight line moves. The first one, bottom line, in this particular case, you've come down. You started out at 358. You get down yesterday to 332. You come down with volume. You bounce with light volume, which we have right now in a monster way. The real kicker is going to be, how do we close? The reason I'm saying how do you close, because what we haven't done yet, we just missed it, is the highs of yesterday. If this backs off at all, then your probability starts getting a little bit higher. If it doesn't back off, that is telling me that the S&P, the SPY, wants to basically, not still, even the lows of, you could run to 347. See, the 342.59, this gets kind of intriguing, actually, looking at it. The 342.59 is the low of the initial downdraft. NDX 100. Let's go take a look at the NDX. So the NDX is still weaker than the SPY out here today. What you have with the NDX is that we're up $9.33 right now. You're $279.27. Bottom line, that if in fact it closes over like the 278.22, which is $1.10 higher than we are, then it could actually run into this 284. You close underneath it, and then let me bring this up. NQ, we're going to bring up the NQ futures so you can see how these babies are shaking out also. Inside the futures, what you have is that we got up into this 11,478, couldn't handle it. You had the first little rundown. The first little rundown came back to the strength that was established out here at 11 o'clock this morning. That being said, we go into the three Qs. We take a look at the three Qs, and what you're going to have is that you're going up with 51 million. You basically, you came down with just a monster. You came down with 110 million as well as 123 million. So the real kicker here is going to be how do you finish off? Because if, in fact, this Q just comes down 1 point, that would be a failure on price and volume. Right now, what you have inside the marketplace is you're bouncing on light volume, but we've been doing that for a long period of time. You fail on price, too, it's going to make a difference big time. Gold market, GDX. Let's go take a look at the GDX, because what we have had out here is this. The gold market, folks, didn't pull back. Well, it pulled back to a lower part of its consolidation, but it did not get smoked as the market got smoked on the way down the last 3 days. What you have here is that you got some real juice inside of this market. And it looks like to me that this thing is ready. The equities, this is. The equities are ready to run for their highs once again. We get the GDX up $1.73. That high that looks like it wants to go after is 45.78. We go take a look at Barrick Gold. Barrick Gold right now, that is trading. Yeah, it's picking its nose up in a big way. That's up $1.25. You get 16 million shares traded. You get a high volume high laying out at 31.22. That wants to go for it. We take a look at Agnico Eagle. Agnico Eagle, same setup. You're at 354. The top of this consolidation is at 84.66. Right now, you're at 82.77. And then if we go over to King Dollar, the thing with King Dollar, which is pretty wild, is that once again, it just couldn't handle price. You know, first time we got over the swing point was yesterday. The small swing was 93,473. Got over it. That was the first time. And, oh my God, look at this. This is crazy. I get this back 6 months. It's the first time since 102.95 that it could even get over a swing point. That being said, guess what? In spades, gave it up again today. So, bottom line, we'll see where this baby is going to shake out. But, and the correlation is kind of interesting. Tommy and I were talking about this morning. Is the correlation so tight that, the dollar had like a three-day bounce? Does the broad market can't stand that bounce in the dollar that dramatic that we start pulling back in the dollar again and the market can go forward? Well, we'll see how this shakes out in next week, week and a half, to see if that correlation is there. Dow Industrials right now up 669, Nasdaq's up 331. S&Ps are up 82. We got gold up 14, silver up 23 cents. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks. The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The Gold Report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The Gold Report is a comprehensive look at the metals sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the Gold Report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow up 674. The Nasdaq's up 345. S&Ps are up 85. Let's go inside the indices and see what's running these babies up, folks. Inside the Dow, you only have one equity that is actually in the negative, and it's only putting... two negative points inside the Dow Industrials. The mover out here is Microsoft. It's pretty wild, man. Microsoft, it's pretty hard to comprehend how much it actually went down yesterday. Now, right back up today, putting 74 positive points. You got Salesforce putting 69, Home Depot 66, United Health 47. You got Walgreens Boots is the only negative one in there. If we go take a look at Microsoft, look at this, man. This is something else, man. So Microsoft... bottom line, oh, it's still down pretty much. Wow, it's pretty intense, man. I didn't realize Microsoft was that high. Yeah, so Microsoft was at, had a high of 232, you know, got into 202 yesterday, and we're trading at 213. We go inside the NDX 100. We take a look at the NDX 100, the strength versus the weakness. You get Zoom up 11.5%. Tesla's up 9.5%. Tesla can't get out of its way, though. It's up $30. Big deal. NVIDIA, good move on NVIDIA, big time. That's up 6.5%. Taken away from it, Lululemon. Lululemon's down 8.5%. You get Netflix off 2.5%. And I believe after the closeout here today, Restoration Hardware, oh, this will be a fun one. Restoration Hardware right now is up $9.96. And what you have here, which is just crazy, folks, there's a 28.31 short position inside of Restoration Hardware. So you just don't want to go short on that equity. CHWY, I believe Chewy's coming out also. Yeah, Chewy's coming out tomorrow. So Chewy's right now up 70 cents, trading 61.50. Let's get a Mike in Tampa. Hey, Mike, what's going on?
How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
Not too bad.
Cool. What are we going to look at today?
Insego, INSG.
INSG. Let's take a look. So this company provides 5G and intelligent device-to-cloud solutions. Lows 391. The high's 1525. You're trading 1090. Okay, so you own this? We're looking to buy it? What are we doing here?
Well, we've talked about this one before, Tom. I was in, I was out. I want to get back in. They on the 4th of September, it came down to that 965, I think, about 4.5 million. I wanted to jump. They had some halfway decent news today. I held because of that low, and it's creeping up on lighter volume today. So I don't know. What do you think?
Yeah, I think it was smart you held. Well, I think it was smart you held for two different reasons. One, that you have that high volume low, and two, it's like, yeah, this market has a heck of a bounce today. But the danger would have been that you don't get the bounce, number one, and number two, if that is just a bounce. Let me put this back in a year. I'll put it a two-year weekly for a second.
Now, yeah. Tom, if you remember, back in May, we looked at this thing, and it came off the top. As a matter of fact, it was, let's see, what was the date on 5-1. Okay, 5-1, yeah. It came down. All right, then it went up, and this was the AB, and we thought it was going to be an ABC down. It came down A to B, and then coming up to C on the 5th,
yeah.
And it came down, and it broke it with volume. It broke that B with a lot of volume, but it didn't go where it needed to go.
No, I'm with you. I would hang tight there. Now, if you're looking at my currency, you see how this when it did break topside. You know, this was powerful, folks, okay? And in 4 weeks, six weeks, it went from $3.94 up to $15. It looks to me that 975 is the number, man. You know, when we came down, it hit 935. But you see what's happening here? At the top of that range, when it broke out of that range, that's what it looks like. And when you do get an expansion of volume like that, it's always dangerous, man. You know what I mean? So,
right.
I just kind of.
Okay, I'll just hold, wait for these lows. And I've been watching that a lot. Just if I see a high volume low, I don't get in. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
That's right. Listen, there's no doubt. What happens is this. I never like to see, if I'm buying an equity, I've seen this when stocks basically haven't got close to their lows yet and it's strong. But when you see high volume come out of an equity on the way down, most times, it's a very large fund that's getting out of it. That's how this normally works. And so it's like they yeah. can't get out of it at one point. Do you know what I'm saying? It's like, okay, so it's a patience deal. Just wait. And, you know, as you said, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't work. You know, sometimes they take off, folks. There's no doubt. Now, that being said, I've seen them take off and come right back at that low again, man. So,
yeah. All right, Tom. Well, thanks so much, buddy.
Okay, man. Have a great one. Have
okay.
a safe one.
All right.
877-927-6648. Let's take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here today, folks. You get Apple's the leader. That's up $4.90. You get Slack down $4.30. Tesla's up $33. You got, Bank of America is up $0.18. You get Workhouse Group. I don't know. Peloton's up $5.30. We got, let's just go look at Tesla for a second. I just want to see how this thing is setting up. Yeah, so Tesla is, you know, up $33 with the bottom down line here, down from 502. We go over to Google. We take a look at Google. And Google got a small bounce going, up $34. If you do go, Slack came out with his numbers last night. Bottom line, what Slack did, Slack basically took out its whole consolidation going all the way back to March 25th. And when you do something like that, that would set up, you could take the top of that, which is $40, you take the bottom of it, which is $27.13, you get, oh my God, this is pretty sick. So you're talking about like $14. Where's $14? Yeah, you're talking about this thing can go to $14. That would be a shocker. They're at $40. Yeah, $14 is game, man. And $15.10 is the high. There you go. So that's what you're probably going to do. $15.10 is the high of the low that was established out here in March. And that's where that baby looks like it wants to go. Lululemon, we take a look at Lululemon. Now, Lululemon came out with some numbers, folks. The numbers were fine. That being said, guess what? When you have markets that have got overextended in an amazing way, bottom line, this Lululemon, you're down $30 right now. Next stop, we're at 319. Next stop looks like it wants to get out to 288. But let me show you something even on the numbers. So watch this. If we bring this up, now, they were looking at, okay, they didn't give guidance going forward. Bottom line is that they did say they have a, you know, great numbers that they come out with. But this is what you have. Last year they did $883 million. This year they did $902. Okay, so that's not a big leap. Last year they made 95 cents. This year they made 66. Now watch this. I was looking at this, and then I just happened to be on the TD Ameritrade network right before I jumped on here, folks. Okay, and the bottom line is that when I take that back a year, I says, okay, so you're taking in less money, but a year ago you're trading at $203, and today you're trading at $319. You figure that one out. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. 877-927-6648. Come right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has developed a daily programming lineup for traders by traders. We start every trading day live at 8:30 a.m. with Tommy O'Brien hosting the morning market kickoff as he starts the day off by breaking down everything you need to know about what's going on for the trading day ahead. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento takes your calls and questions live on the air for the opening bell as he hosts Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Trading Hour. At 11 a.m., it's Kevin Hanks and Alex Coffey from TD Ameritrade Network with Fast Market. Basil Chapman at noon with the Tiger Technicians Hour. Steve Rhodes hosts the Trader's Edge at 1 p.m. Dave White with the Power Trading Hour at 2 p.m. And Tom O'Brien closes out the day for the final hour of trading live from 3 till 4. Don't miss a second of our daily programming lineup. Tune in to Tiger TV every trading day live at TFNN.com. Educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow. Dow's up 668. The Nasdaq's up 351. S&Ps are up 83. We go over. Let's go take a look at a few of the transports out here, folks. Transports. Bottom line is that pretty amazing that even when we came down the last couple of days, they just didn't do much. That being said, you know, they do get a bid inside of them right now. Let me go take a look at see what's actually moving this. So, yeah, it's not the airlines. Okay, so we got FTX. You're gonna have some of these. Yeah, FedEx is at highs. That's up $5 right now. Because we're going to have kicking off here, folks. Not highs, but the bottom line, it's up. What we are going to have kicking off here is that you are going to have the holiday season kicking off before we know it. Bottom line is that right now you're running into September 9th, right? Bottom line, before we know it, you're going to be Christmas shopping. UPS, UPS is a powerhouse, man. UPS is actually an ABC structure on the way up. It's a monster one, too. In fact, if I put this, it's a pretty tough one to really. Yeah, on a longer term basis, you got 37. Wow. You could. Nah, it came down with too much volume. It actually, in March, it actually came down with too much volume in order to basically be an ABC structure on the way up. It came down a few times with too much volume. We got to take a look at what is intriguing here. Let me see the CLAC and AMD. AMD was up earlier. CLAC, a rejected lower price at 172. You're at 176 right now. AMD, that's up 356. That doesn't have enough juice behind it. But bottom line, the reason I was looking for those folks, and in fact, let's go look at the SMHs, because these chip stocks love taking the NDX 100, which takes the rest of the market up and down. And, you know, we'll see when you take a look at the SMHs today, they're up $5.65. And, you know, we have the contraction of volume is basically all over the place. That's the bottom line. But if you hold price, it's going to make a difference. In fact, that's what it comes down to. Let me see this. So we got, let me go take a look at Nike for one of our tigers out here. He's looking at the volume on Nike. So Nike is up $3. You're going after your high volume high, the 117. You know, you're at 3.6 million right now. And Nike wants higher price. Now, see, this is, you know, you did come down to the 5.1, but the bottom line is that this hardly retraced at all. When you're looking, when we get downdrafts like we got in the last 3 days, folks, the bottom line is that what you want to be looking at is that what are the equities that did not get slammed? That's a big deal. Let's go over to the banks for a second. JP Morgan. Yeah, it's still a tight consolidation, you know. And the banks didn't get slammed, by the way, and not even close. That being said, the bottom line is that they haven't done much. And what does happen in larger corrections is that the bottom line is that the banking structure always seems to be the last sector that falls apart. We go over to the Gold Bugs Index. We take a look at the Gold Bugs Index. Now, the volume on this is going to be crucial tonight, and I expect we're going to get the volume because the gold equities are actually getting volume inside of them. Because what you're going to see, if you are in the metals market, what you're going to see here is that, you know, we've been in a consolidation, but we're breaking the trend line from its highs with conviction, and with conviction means wide price spread, accelerated volume. Now, what I don't get the volume till 8 o'clock at night. Inside the Gold Bugs Index, as well as the XAU. We take a look at the XAU. What I expect we're going to see here, yeah, it did. The XAU also broke it hasn't broken the consolidation, but what ends up happening is that when you're in a longer consolidation, bottom line is that how you come out of the bottom of it is very important. And what we had done inside the gold market and the gold equities is that we came back to the bottom of the consolidation. This is when the market was getting smoked. You came back to the bottom, very small retracement. You took off again with the market taking off, and you get the price movement with it. That's saying that these could be very large ABC structures on the way up. So it's going to be really intriguing watching this whole thing shake out. If we go back over to the silver market and we take a look at the September contract, no, let's go to the December, SIZ, yeah. Okay, so you go to the December contract inside silver. That's going to need a little more juice. That hasn't peaked its head up yet. Gold's peaked its head up. Silver hasn't. That being said, let's go take a look at a few silver equities. Okay, First Majestic needs a little more juice. Pan American Silver. Not bad. Could use a little more juice. The Endeavor used a little more juice. Hecla, this is intriguing, man. So be interesting to see whether gold overtakes silver once again. I'd rather silver stay stronger, because what we've had, the silver market is really tricky, folks. Yeah. Hecla needs a little more juice, too. So to finish that thought, what has happened, what happens in the metals market is this. When silver and the silver equities seem to be stronger than gold, gold really likes to take off. When gold is stronger and the old equities are stronger, silver can go along, or silver can break the party. That's how this thing shakes out. Because when silver breaks the party, what ends up happening is they sell the silver contract down fast and furious, and gold ends up going along with it. You know, bottom line, it's not quite as cut and dried as I'm doing it there, but that is the basis of what, when you actually put that together. That's how this thing basically shakes out. We go take a look at the, let's go take a look at Apple. So Apple out here, no doubt, bottom line, came down hard. You came down to your breakout area. Let me see. Did it hit 100? 110? 106. Now, you know, Apple's setting up. It wants to go back to this breakout area. Now, in Apple's case, folks, that is a normal pullback in an equity that could go higher. You know, you can see the breakout is clear as a bell. You know, breakout was from 96. Next day, you know, went to 106, monster volume, run all the way up to 137. And, you know, what equities just love to do is they love to come back into the breakout area. And if, in fact, that it wants to go higher, what you'll see is that you come back into the breakout area, you come back with lighter volume, and then once again, you take off topside, and you're looking to go after those highs, and you're looking to go after those highs with some juice behind them. Royal Gold, let's go take a look at Royal Gold. Now, this is a streamer. Yeah, and this has been consolidating quite some time. Now, this has been the strongest gold equity out there. That being said, we have been going sideways, going all the way back to May. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Dow Industrials right now trading up 623. Nasdaq up 350. S&P's up 80. Come right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 575. Nasdaq's up 318. S&Ps are up 73. We got a question in the Tiger's Den here about, let's see, the QID. Okay, so buying the QID. So the QID, folks, okay, is the 200% UltraShot Pro Share. Bottom line, you get an inverse correlation with the NDX 100. So let's first go over to the NQs and take a look at the NQs. So what we have with the NQs out here is that, you know, the bottom line is that you're going to close where at 11,412. You close under 11,404, that's telling me that, guess what, that wouldn't be a bad trade. We take a look at the Qs themselves, because what you're actually doing is that you're shorting the Qs double. And in that case, pull this back. Okay, pull it this way. Come on, this way. There we go. We go that way. You get a close. Pull this up. Okay, so in this case, the high of yesterday was 278. It's 278.22. You get a close into 278.22. The bottom line is that you're getting a buy on the QID wouldn't be a bad deal. And what that is this. You get over yesterday's high. Now, we're over that right now. We're over that by, well, it's 18 cents. Now we're over it by 35 cents. Bottom line, if you get it under the 22, then you're going to have a failure in price and failure in volume. You don't get it under there. Bottom line is that, yes, it can go higher. You know, and you can expect what we're going to have out here coming right into the close. We're going to have a little volatility coming into this close. The real question is, you know, does the first leg, okay, so what we just did out here, even inside the S&Ps, you can see someone came in and they came in hard in the S&Ps and they just sold them down. You know, that being said, guess what? You know, the S&Ps normally, you know, that move's not that extreme. The bottom line is that they sold them down 14 points, and normally 14 points would be a lot. That being said, what you'd have to do in the S&Ps to basically say that, okay, you get a failure in price coming in, is that I'd want them to bust out the 3404 number one. That was the lows of the last downdraft out here where we had sellers, and that was at 2 o'clock this afternoon. And that's going to be a hard number to bust out. That's the real bottom line, because what you are going to have out here is you're going to have the bulls and bears fighting like crazy, because this is a very important day, folks, okay? The reason is that we had come down so hard and so fast, you get a bounce going. And the bottom line is that, you know, the bounce started out slow. It accelerated on price. As it accelerated on price, the bottom line, it took out. Let me show you. As soon as when the NQs actually took out the highs of yesterday, that is when, and that high of yesterday, and this is the number you want to keep your eye on, is that 11,404. When it took that out, the S&P took off. Now, as I'm speaking, the bottom line, you're getting back underneath this again. So you get back underneath this, what you'd like to see if you're on the bearish side is that what you would be looking for is you'd be looking for that it not only closes underneath there, but then you would actually get down into that 2 o'clock time frame, the two o'clock time frame, and basically close below that, which is the 367, you know, which can be done. I mean, the bottom line inside the NQs, you know, move 50 and 100 points in about a heartbeat. And one of the tigers want me to put a 20-day moving average on this. Okay, so let me see this. So what's this on the Qs? Let's see what we got here, Jeff. So on the Qs, you know, I know you were talking about this yesterday, Jeff, that the bottom line is that it hit the 50-day. And this is there's no doubt, man. This thing just touched the 50-day yesterday in a huge way. Now I'll put the 20 on here for you. They put the 20. It's below. I mean, it's way below the 20. Oh, I see. What do you think? There's going to be a bounce to the 20? Bottom line is, yeah, it's way below the 20. It hit the 50 perfectly. If we go take a look at the SPY, inside of the SPY, we bang that up. Yeah, the SPY never hit it. You know. That being said, the SPX, the cash. Oh, this is pretty cool. So Jeff from New York is saying is that the SPX hit it perfectly. Now, what's really cool about the SPX hitting it perfectly, folks, is this. When I'm actually looking at markets and making a decision where I think markets are going up or down, I always use the cash. The reason being is that you can push around the futures. Big players can push around the futures. The cash market, okay, is only the cash market when the markets are opened and all 500 equities are trading. So it's very hard to project a number inside the cash market versus the future market. That's how that baby is set up. And that's why the cash market is pretty cool in that context. Let's just go over and take a look at the S&Ps once again. You got to sell them, man. Look at this. This is pretty cool. You don't see this a lot. And what I mean by don't seeing it a lot, you actually, let's see, you got 8 minutes inside the S&Ps. Your first sell down, okay, big sell down, 91,000 contracts. Well, the second sell down's bigger, folks, and it did break the 2 o'clock time frame. So let me go look at the NQs for a second, NQU0, because what that is saying, what that's setting up, we don't have it in the NQs yet. What that's setting up, though, is that saying that could very well be coming at us. We have the first sell down was 13,000. The second sell down was 16,000. And right now you're going to be going on the third one in a minute. And that is saying that they're going to try to basically get this thing lower as we come in. Now, getting the S&P lower was quite a feat, you know, because the bottom line is that what we did have out here is that the NQs were still weaker than the S&P, but yet they took the S&P and they just blew away the low that was established at 2 o'clock this afternoon. So what we have inside the S&P right now is that you still got a heck of a bounce going. That being said, though, you're back to the 12 o'clock time frame. And what you do know is this. You know you have a seller inside the marketplace right now. That's the difference. When you know you have a seller, when you see this type of volume come out, it's a problem, man. You know, volume on the way down is that's not you and I basically trading, folks, okay? That is one of the big monsters that are out here and say, sell, 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 throw it at them, give it them all. I don't want anything left, and that's exactly how this baby is setting up right now. Dow's up 507, Nasdaq's up 291, S&Ps are up 67. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by, as well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 554, Nasdaq's up 334, S&P's are up by 75. Bottom line, folks, is that it looks to me these prices have held. So, you know, you don't have the volume behind the move, but bottom line, you have prices that did held. And that is saying that you could get up into the, like the spike, you go to that 342.59. That's the low of the first downdraft. Now, the Qs are in a different situation, man. You know, the Qs out here, they're almost at their highs. And if, you know, the 278.22, we're a buck over it right now, $1.20. That is saying that the Qs can actually get to the same place. And if that's the case, that would be, well, no, it wouldn't be that much. It's 284.41. That's how that baby would be set up. So bottom line is that you are going to have dramatically lighter volume. And let's see, is today Wednesday? Yeah, Wednesday, okay. So look at this. This is anemic volume. You're at 558 million right now on the NYSE. So we'll end up doing like 850, 900 million on the NYSE. We take a look at the composite. The composite's at 3.1 billion. So that should do about 3.8, 3.9 billion. So the composite bottom line will have some juice. The ETF structures, no doubt, you get a big contraction on that volume. Inside the Qs right now, we get 58 million. That baby was coming into, it's coming into a monster. That's coming into 123 million. And we go take a look at the SPY out here. And what you have with the SPY, Same type of setup inside the SPY. The SPY is coming into 148 million to get 76 million. You get a bounce going, no doubt. The differential out here inside of the SPY is that the SPY has not got to the highs of yesterday. 342.64 is the high. 342.46 is the number it got to. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night. Have a safe night. Come back and visit us tomorrow morning. Tommy kicks us off 8:30 in the morning. Great show. Please tell your friends to go to YouTube, hit TFNN, subscribe. It's free. Yeah, go get them, folks.